Online, she called herself Jihad Jane. And tonight, this Pennsylvania woman is facing charges that she tried to recruit and help terrorists around the world. A federal indictment now indicates Colleen LaRose worked with several other people in the United States and in Europe, plus in South Asia, using the internet to recruit men for violent jihad or holy war, and to recruit women to use their passports to travel in support of their causes. The feds also say LaRose, whose picture was posted on our corporate cousin MySpace, agreed to travel to Europe to carry out a murder of her own. Catherine Herridge with new developments from D.C. tonight. Catherine, according to this indictment, she actually did make it to Europe, but we now know her alleged target is still alive.
Well, Shep, late tonight we had confirmation from a federal law enforcement source that the Swedish citizen Jihad Jane was apparently targeting was this cartoonist Lars Vilks, who drew that controversial image of the prophet Muhammad, the one where Muhammad's head is on the body of a dog. Now, that image led to multiple threats on his life, and Vilks now lives with around-the-clock police protection. We're also being told that a series of arrests in Ireland, about 7 arrests earlier today, are also related to this American case, Shep.
Huh. And we're learning more about this woman, Jihad Jane, from her internet postings.
Well, we are. According to court documents, in June 2008, LaRose, seen here in a new picture we just obtained, it's a mugshot from Texas, posted a comment on YouTube stating that she is, quote, desperate to do something somehow to help the suffering Muslim people. LaRose allegedly stated in a series of messages that she wanted to wage jihad and die as a martyr herself. This video was embedded on LaRose's MySpace page, and it purports to explain the rewards and the afterlife for those who die for Islam. Now, to that end, the indictment alleges that LaRose was part of a broader conspiracy to recruit women on the net who had passports, which allowed them to travel freely around Europe to commit these violent acts, Shep.
You know, the Justice Department says this points to an evolving threat.
Well, this is a highly significant case in many respects. The use of the internet to recruit, to raise money, to wage jihad are seen by federal law enforcement sources as part of this growing body of evidence that the threat within the United States is evolving. And in this case, a woman is at the center of the alleged conspiracy. LaRose is also the first American woman to face terrorism charges in this country, which include conspiracy to commit murder. So in many ways, this is a watershed indictment, Shep.
Catherine Herridge with developing news from Washington. Catherine, thanks. Well, there